Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot.
Hey, tea sippers. Good afternoon. So I got some extra tea for you guys. So if you do not know, right now, cupcake is trending, Suki is trending. This entire situation is crazy. So as we all know, 2 days ago, Cupcake dropped a track called How to Rob, just like, you know, the 50 Cent track. And she went in on so many people in the industry, from Cardi B to Meg Thee Stallion to Offset, Lil Baby, 6ix9ine, Suki Hanna, Lizzo, the list goes on, honey, even Lady Gaga. So to Suki's credit, I will give her some credit, she did have the balls, okay, the guspa to respond to Cupcake. And Suki did pretty good. You know, I don't think her response was too bad. You know, I think she did pretty good on her track. To me, Suki is definitely a roaster, okay? She will roast that ass. She got jokes. I've seen her roast Big Chop, Chief Keef's homeboy. She went in on his ass, okay? So Suki can definitely roast. I would definitely give her that. So a lot of people are really excited about Suki dropping the track and responding because she was one of the first ones to respond. We're still waiting to see if Meg or Cardi B will respond. They probably won't, but Suki was like, fuck it, hold my beer, I got this. So Suki went in. I'm just going to play a small snippet, 15 seconds, honey. Y'all going to have to go listen to the whole snippet yourself. Go ahead and check this out.
I pure on cup, pussy hoe, you re-rock. How you gonna rob a bitch when I heard your knees knocking? Yeah, I got a man, yeah, I got that bitch hot. She mad, she ain't really bad enough to be a thot. Ugly ass hoe, you will never be a fox. Looking like me, I said a vaccine shot.
All right, no more. So y'all heard it. If you need more, go listen to it. It's on my Instagram or just go Google. Anyways, today I was minding my damn business, okay? And all of a sudden, I seen Cupcake's ass trending number one on social media. I'm like, oh, Lord, I'm scared to see what done happen now. Who is Cupcake about to drag now? Well, Cupcake done came out with a part two. And this was solely for Suki. She went in, honey. When I tell you, she killed Suki. I'm sorry. I don't know if there's any coming back from that, sis. Because she went there. I mean, she talked about her OnlyFans. The song is called The Gag Is. She used Suki's OnlyFans picture. You know, when she was throwing up all that nut and stuff. You know what I mean? She used that picture. And she drug her for literally, I think it was like a whole minute and 40 seconds straight. It was cold. Now, a lot of folks are in their feelings because they feel like, you know, Cupcake took it too far by mentioning Suki's kids. They're saying that, you know, children should be off limits. But again, I come from the era of, you know, real hip hop, where Jay-Z said he left a condom in Nas's baby's car seat. Okay.
I came in your belly back seat, skeeted in your Jeep, left condoms on your baby seat.
So children have never been off topic in hip hop, unfortunately. So some people are mad about that. But to me, I think that's kind of harsh to say that you might, you know, harm her kids. But again, it's all gonna stay on wax. So y'all go ahead and listen to this snippet really quick.
From a whole motherfucking Rolls Royce sitting next to Suki Hyundai. Oh, you got three kids, all them bitches dead. Buh, 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 through their head. Now bury them in your loose pussy, cause them front rules cost too much bread. We talking down on our black kings, like if you broke, you can't get no butt. Bitch, you got a whole man, but got an OnlyFans. Bitch, that don't add up.
All right, no more. I can only play a small snippet, but like I said, she killed it. So then what happened is that basically everybody ran to Suki's page and was like, oh my God, ooh, she dissed you, ooh. You know how we used to do back in the day, honey, when you play dozens. And so Suki went to her Twitter page and she wrote, dead, nah. Basically saying that, nah, she didn't kill shit. So then Cupcake replied back and was like, you spoke on my mother, so I spoke on your kids. Family is family. Fuck them bastards. So Cupcake's ass, she wants all the damn smoke, okay? Because Suki says something about her mother in her diss track. And some people are saying that Cupcake's mother is dead. But then I heard other people saying that her mother is not dead. So I don't know if her mother is dead or alive. I'm not sure. I don't know the whole backstory. But people are saying that that's why Cupcake went so hard is because Suki spoke on her mother as well. So like I said, again, all is fair in love and hip hop, okay? Or shit, Twitter diss tracks, I don't know. But yeah, social media definitely went crazy. So this entire situation is definitely crazy, okay? So anyhow, on to other news. I have to talk about this whole B. Simone situation. This is going viral and it's causing a big debate on social media. A lot of people are just over B. Simone and her antics. B. Simone, a.k.a. the Manifest Queen, who was accused of stealing other people's manifestations to make her damn book, okay? So now what's going on is this. If you guys don't know, B. Simone's ass has been dick-riding DaBaby for months now, okay? That is, she's his biggest fan. She wants to be with him. Even though he was clearly with his black baby's mother and they were trying to make things work, B. Simone was always dropping hints that she wants to be with DaBaby.
Time out, shoot real quick.
Okay, whatever you want, boy. All right. Okay, hurry.
I appreciate you, baby.
But I can be your boo. Pretty f***ing with me. I'm gonna need like three of you.
So if you guys don't know, DaBaby has been kind of creeping with Danny Lee for a while now, and they finally made it official. He finally left his baby's mother, and now he's officially with Danny Lee, and, you know, they're making these little TikTok videos together, and, you know, everybody's like, oh, they're so cute. So I guess people have been saying things like, oh, you know, he's with Danny Lynn, poor B. Simone, So B. Simone, out of nowhere, decided to take to her social media page and talk about it. She's basically putting Danny Lee on this huge pedestal and basically saying that she got with the baby, or the baby chose her because she's beautiful, she's Latina, she speaks two languages. I mean, just gassing the Latina female community up like a motherfucker, okay? Y'all go ahead and check this out, and I'm gonna come back with the rest of my commentary.
I mean, you know, Danny, it's she fly as fuck. That's just what it is, so. Stop crying. I'm sad. I know she got good music. We get it.
She's fly. She's like really dope.
She's beautiful. Like, and her curls. Her curls are blonde and they're not fried off. When I dyed my hair blonde, I was bald.
That's another point for her.
And she could sing without auto-tune. I need a little T-Pain. I just need a little bit. It ain't gotta be much, but give me a little bit. And her body is natural. And she's Dominican, so she probably speaks fucking Spanish. Mm. I've only met her like twice. I met her at Wild'n Out in another event.
So she got the cheat code.
So beautiful. She looks just like she looks like in her pictures. She looks just like that in person.
Well.
I mean, I see why the nigga like her.
We win some, we lose some.
We win some, we lose some, but we live to fight another day.
There we go.
I gotta lose weight.
Come on, champ. That's why we're going to Runyon Canyon?
I'm not going to Runyon today. I'm hungry.
What?
No. So we can start the diet Monday. It's the middle of the week. I'm not starting no diet in the middle of the week. Danny's waist is getting snatched. And she could dance. She choreographed bop.
Really?
I could dance too, though. I freestyle.
I got video footage of you dancing.
Do you?
Yes.
Don't release it.
I won't. Well, I mean...
Okay, here's the thing. Dominican bitches, they already have the upper hand. Because it's something in their blood that genetically makes them sexy. That's the problem. I'm going to start telling people I'm Puerto Rican.
I see it.
You can see I'm going to be Puerto Rican? Just a little bit. Like, bitch, she from DR, I'm from PR. Okay? Danny's from DR, I'm from PR. Like, wait, Puerto Rican.
So you really trying to... Go another round. You might stay in the fight.
Should I keep fighting?
You gotta keep fighting.
I tell you one thing though, I ain't disrespecting nobody's relationship. So now that they public, I'ma leave them alone.
You sure?
I'm gonna leave that boy alone. He was pulling her hair. Jesus. And I got tracks. Don't pull my hair like that. You can pull her real shit. I would have said if he would have pulled my shit. Take it easy, nigga. This is tracks, nigga. And the thing about B. Simone, here's the thing. I'm not a hater. And the bitches fly.
Facts. You know?
How did she get so pretty? Why is her skin like that? Her teeth white as hell. You think she had braces?
She had to have braces.
She had to have braces. Because I'm on the way to veneers. I'm a doctor's appointment away from veneers. God damn. I think my teeth done. Fucking with Danny. Should I close my gap?
Hell no. You're crazy.
That bitch is cute. She's cute. She's cute and she's Latin. She just bought her family a fucking house in DR.
Stop.
Fuck buying my family a house. I can't even buy me a house yet. I still stay in an apartment. Fuck. Bitch is cute. She's cute. She's cute. She's successful. She got her own money. The bitch.
Let me get you back.
I know the song. Okay. I know the song.
It's just so good.
But I know it's a good record.
I'm not playing that. I don't want
to. She makes hits. I get it. You don't have to keep singing it, though. We know easy. We know
I love it.
I'm just saying. Okay, you don't know no other songs?
Sorry.
I know. It's catchy.
In the fast lane. All right. You got a little voice.
Her, been following her since My Little Baby. That's my favorite song by Danny Lake, period. Beautiful. She's Latin. Latin bitches already have the upper hand, bitches. Speak two languages and fucking spiciness is in your blood. That's not fair.
Okay. Chili peppers.
Chili peppers, bitch. Like, Latin bitches are, they come out the vagina sexy. Like, how are you sexy at two, bitch? You're a fucking infant. Why are you walking around in diapers sexy? I had to grow into my sexiness, bitch. I'm still working on it. God damn.
And that's why we're going to get something to eat and not go to Runyon Canyon. Just let me know. I just want to.
What I'm saying is.
For clarification.
Here's the clarification. Okay. Danny looks great. Her body is toned. She's a dancer. She already has the upper hand. I didn't grow up in athletic and dancing. So what I'm saying, I'm already behind. I'm 30. She's in her early 20s. I already have a disadvantage. My metabolism is slowing the fuck down as we speak. You say, are you braking because of traffic? How you slowing down? This is my metabolism. So what I'm saying is I will start my diet Monday, but today I'm going to eat.
Let's see. Okay. So let's go to like a vegan restaurant.
I don't want vegan either.
Salad.
I like dairy. Someday. They don't need my approval. John and Danny don't need my approval. But what I'm saying is, I do approve. Because they're a sexy fucking couple. And she's successful.
Facts.
She's successful. She Facts. Doesn't need him for his money. She has her own bread. She has number one hits. She's beautiful, young, and
she's Danny
rich.
Lay.
And Okay.
I just love her.
But why do you say her name like that? You never say my name like that. You're my fucking stylist.
Okay.
She's Danny Lay. All right. Like, hey, it's a little accent
over the E. Okay. I thought it was over the E or the I.
The accent is probably over the I or the E. But what I'm saying is, say B. Simone like that, nigga. Like, when you say Danny Lay, you could say B. Simone. Like, put an accent, put some French shit on my shit.
We'll see.
Walk down the aisle and drop the flowers. Like, I didn't make it. No, a bad bitch made it. I'm not fighting for this nigga no more. I'm not disrespecting their relationship. She's bomb as fuck.
Wedding. Hilarious.
All right, so you guys just heard what B. Simone had to say, and I, for one, was not feeling it. Then she decided to reply back to the people dragging her. So I want you guys to go ahead and watch her second video. Y'all go ahead and check this out.
I wasn't going to address this shit, but here it fucking goes. This generation is so fucking stupid that y'all think if it trends, it's true. Y'all think I don't see the blogs in the fucking comments? I've been in the blogs all of 2020. Y'all want to know the truth? Y'all want to know what's really going on? Siri knows the truth. Siri, who is the baby's girlfriend?
The baby's girlfriend is the world-renowned comedian B. Simone, who always says baby girl.
Period.
Manifested like
Thank
you. System glitching. It appears the baby's girlfriend is the thicker.
What?
The beautiful.
Huh?
The Dominican mommy, Dani Leigh.
All right, she cute, but...
Would you like me to play the song easy while you punch the air?
Bitch, I'm fine.
Would you like me to restock your coloring book?
All right, bitch, don't play with me. I'll call Alexa.
Would you like me to locate a surgeon for your BBL? You're gaining weight.
All right, so you guys just saw the second video. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys everybody's response on social media. A lot of people had things to say. A lot of folks were not feeling this, and they found nothing funny about it. So y'all go ahead and check this out. Alright, so you guys just saw the comments, the tweets, and what folks had to say. So a lot of people are really upset about what B. Simone said. And I know some people feel like, well, what's the big deal about her saying it? You know, black men do tend to choose Latino women. It's not a big deal. But the reason why that's a big deal is the fact that, once again, this woman is belittling black women. Regardless if it's a joke or not. And even if black men choose Latino women or choose women of other races more than they choose black women, I should be Simone reiterate that, especially with her big platform. She has like 5 million followers or something like that on Instagram. Why would you reiterate that? Why would you tell the entire world that black women are not as good as? Why would you put Latino women or any women of another race on a pedestal? You will never see a Latino woman with a huge platform like that get up and say that black women are better, black women have better bodies, they're prettier. You'll never see an Asian woman with a platform of that size say the same thing. Other races are loyal to their race first. And this is sad that shit like this constantly happens in the black community. The problem is she can scream, hoop, and holler and do all that yelling that she wants to, but I know low self-esteem when I see it. Okay. The problem is B. Simone is bothered. She's one of them girls where she was always like the cute light skinned girl, and it made her feel a way around other girls, particularly probably dark skinned girls. Now that she's in the industry, she's around chicks that are even badder than she is, and it's fucking with her. Okay. Cause she's probably used to just being around, you know, regular chicks, you know, in her neighborhood, whatever. And she was always the bad chick. But now in the industry, you got chicks with their bodies done and they're pretty in the face. And it makes her feel away. So all that hooping and hollering tells me everything I need to know. First of all, it's never okay to sexualize a child. I don't like the sexualization jokes, especially being that we live in a climate that's ripe with child kidnapping, molestation, and things going on like that with children. So to sexualize, you know, Latina babies, it's not okay. Now, I see a lot of people online saying it's just a joke. It's not a big deal. To me, personally, it would be a joke if this was like a 1 minute video, if this was a, you know, 59 second Instagram video. This girl spoke for close to 8 minutes while she talked down to herself and uplifted another race of women for damn near 8 minutes. At that point, it's not a joke. You could literally see the sadness behind her eyes, that she really felt bothered and she really feels bad, and that she's really covered in those features. She talked about Dani Lynn's hair, her hair texture, her hair color, you know, how nice it was. It's not, you know, damaged from her dyeing it blonde. And then she also went on to talk about how in that video where the baby pulls Dani Lee's hair, that couldn't have been her because she has tracks in her hair and her hair would have came out. As if all black women are bald headed, as if we don't have our own hair underneath wigs and tracks and stuff. I just wasn't liking the way that she kept trying to disparage black women all the while uplifting Latina women. It just didn't make any sense to me. She also talked about Dani Lee's body and the fact that her body's natural. And I will give Dani Lee props for having a natural body. You know what I'm saying? But the way she talked about it, you could tell that's probably the body she wants as well. But Dani Lee's just a naturally thin girl. But I mean, the way she just fetishized her was really disturbing. And then she kept reiterating that she doesn't want to disrespect the baby's relationship. Now, I find it funny that now that he's with this Dominican woman that you feel like you can't compete with, now you want to fall back. Now you don't want to be disrespectful. But he was with his black baby's mother for years. And you had no problem being disrespectful. You had no problem lusting after him, even on national television. So it's funny because you thought you're badder than his baby's mother. It didn't matter. But now that you've met your match with Dani Lee, now they're saying, well, I'm going to fall back and I wish them well. Well, why didn't you have the same energy when he was with his baby's mother? You know, so that it just says a lot. You know, y'all can say that these are jokes, but for, you know, all jokes are wrapped in a little bit of truth. And I've never been one to really support self-deprecating humor, because that's what this was. This was self-deprecating humor. Just like with Amber Rose trying to, I don't care and I'll be a slut and I'm a proud slut and all that bullshit. And then a few years later, she was boo-hooing because, you know, people kept calling her a slut. You know, it's like you get what you put out there. And I feel like B. Simone definitely feels a way because she wants to be one of these pretty IG girls. And don't get me wrong, I think B. Simone is a very beautiful woman. But I feel like she's not content where she's at. She keeps talking about all these accolades that Dani Lee has. She has her own job. She makes her own money. She's a singer. She's talented. She can dance. Well, B. Simone, last time I checked, you could do the same thing. You rap, you sing, you dance, you were on Wildin' Out. So why are you degrading yourself and bringing yourself down and along with other black women when you're just as good as she is? You're very talented in your own right. So this just goes to show you that people who scream the loudest, all that manifestation bullshit and all that, you know, I am black woman, hear me roar and I'm a strong woman. A lot of it is bullshit. This woman is literally in her car, you know what I'm saying, having a pity party because the baby didn't choose her. B. Simone wants to be one of these girls whose name ring bells for their body and their looks, like a Ari Fletcher or a Jada Weta or, you know, Dani Lee or, however, you know, whatever Instagram girl model. That's what she wants to be attached to. She wants her name to ring bells like that. She's not content with the fact that when you say B. Simone, you just think goofy comedian on Wildin' Out. She wants her names to ring bells like that so that way she too can pull a baller in the industry. But it's not going to happen if you're sitting here bigging up somebody else to the point where you have to immerse your own self in self-deprecating humor. So I just found the whole situation just really distasteful. Like I said, to me, it would be a joke if she just, you know, cracked a quick joke and it was just, you know, a minute long. But the fact that she went on this weird 8-minute rant about how pretty this girl was, how nice her body was, her hair texture, she's Dominican, even went as far as to sexualize Latina children, I don't find humor in that. Some of y'all saying it's just a joke. I don't find it funny. Not with all the shit that's going on out here with child sex trafficking. I don't find it funny at all. You know, let's not sexualize children because of their race or their background. And also, I don't know if you know this, B. Simone, but you don't have to be Latina or light-skinned to be able to speak more than one language, okay? Many of us speak and understand more than one language. And guess what? Shocker, some of us are dark-skinned. You can speak multiple languages regardless of your ethnicity. So there was a lot of, you know, just, there was a lot of weird energy coming from that whole conversation with her stylist. I wasn't feeling it. I don't think that you have to, you know, bring down your own race or your own ethnic background to big up somebody else. The fact that she now wants to, you know, start claiming that she's Puerto Rican, is it that serious? And then you wonder why people of other races think that they're better than black women when you have a black woman who has a huge platform. Okay, this is a black woman that's also on television who has a huge following, and she's basically telling the entire world that Latina women are better than black women. And so much to the point where she wants to start saying that she's Puerto Rican. And y'all can say it's just a joke, you're taking stuff too seriously. But like I said before, there's always a little bit of truth in every joke. But y'all go ahead and support the foolishness. I'm going to sit back and sip my damn tea, honey, okay? So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Let me know your thoughts on this entire crazy situation. How do you guys feel about the whole back and forth with Suki Hanna and Cupcake? Are you team Cupcake? Do you think Cupcake won? Are you team Suki? Me personally, I think Cupcake ate. She killed it, okay? And then last but not least, let me know what you guys think about all of this mess with B. Simone getting drugged on social media by what she said concerning Dani Leigh and DaBaby and how she just kept giving her so much props and, you know, uplifting the Latina community, meanwhile disrespecting her own community to uplift another. So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Make sure you thumbs up the video if you agree. Last but not least, make sure you share the video. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so that way you can be down with the notification squad. Go ahead and leave a comment. Talk to y'all later. Deuces.